Welcome back to Market Headlines. 2021 state budget deficit. From previously predicted to be around 4.2% of GDP, government has revised it to be 5.2% of the GDP. To keep the effectivity of deficit, government is about to redesign state budget for the next year.
The government and the House of Representatives has agreed in principle on 2021 state budget assumptions with a deficit of 5.2% of gross domestic product. These aim to bolster the economy from the coronavirus-induced recession. To keep it remain effective, government is about to redesign state budget for next year. Suharto Manuarfa, as the Minister of National Development Planning Agency, stated that the increase in state budget deficit should have significant impact to the economic recovery. Therefore, it needs to be calculated firmly so that the state budget deficit can be used in maximum.
Jadi kalau ada pertambahan setiap 1% dari defisit ini, berapa kira-kira pertumbuhan ekonomi yang kita bisa ampuh dan menciptakan lapangan kerja sejumlah berapa orang? Itu yang harus kita desain ulang dalam beberapa hari ke depan ini. Jadi memang kami mohon untuk sabar.
Focus of state budget redesignings will stay in touch for developing priority sectors, including industrial, tourism, social and health, and food sectors. All of these sectors are expected to create more jobs fields. From Jakarta, Raja Pamo for IDX Channel.
So it has been finalized. The government has decided to widen the 2021 state budget deficit. The deficit increase will impact on the government's rising expenditure reserves, which according to Finance Minister, Indonesia has 179 trillion in expenditure reserve. As it contains huge amounts of financial risk, the new setup of budget deficit has raised concerns from many economists. And therefore, right now in the studio, live by Zoom, we're going to have a deeper discussion about this with Fahrul Fulfian, as the Chief Economist of Trimega. Hello, sir. Thank you for time with us. How are you? Hello, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for your time with us. So, sir, there is an interesting fact in here that the government has decided to widen up 2021 state budget deficit to 5.2% of Indonesia's gross domestic product from the initial plans of 4.3%. So what's your perspective on this? Is this necessary enough for you?
I think this is a precautionary action doing by the government. As there is a risk that in the 2021, the economic recovery should be slower than expected. If that's so, the economic recovery is slower than expected, so the wider budget deficit is necessary for this situation.
Oh yes, sir. So, then you say that this is necessary, but with the number of 5.2%, do you think that is realistic enough for you?
For me, this is realistic enough, but there is a big underlying assumption that makes that the state budget deficit at 5.2% to be reliable for the for our economy. It is about the pace of the economic recovery. If the economic recovery next year is recovery comes at the fast pace, the tax revenue likely to grow fast also next year. If that's the case, the 5.2% of the fiscal deficit wouldn't be reachable if our government revenue is likely to grow fast also.
All right, so you mentioned about it is reachable, but do you think that this is still in the safe zone?
I think it is still in the safe zone. Because based on our rules, the maximum of government debt to GDP should not exceed 60% at the current situation. Assuming a 6.3% government state budget deficit to be reached by the end of this year, it should be between 38 to 40%. So it is still below the threshold.
All right, sir. So when we mentioned about President Jokowi's statements before, President Jokowi stated that this state budget deficit will aim to support the economic recovery and also sectoral transformations. Between two entities, between the sectoral transformations and also economic recovery, which one do you think deserves more spotlight?
I think what we need to most spotlight is about the sectoral transformation. As we know that the current disruption due to the COVID-19 virus is currently creating a sudden shift in the behavior, both in the consumers and the producers. And we currently employ high-tech equipment in our job. So sectoral transformation is more important. So the focus will be in how Indonesia can build the efficiency and effectiveness and the economic growth through the sectoral transformation.
All right, sir. So when we talk about sectoral transformations, which one of the sector that you think deserves more spotlight from the government?
The sector that deserves spotlight from the government is the tertiary sector. Because currently, we see that the sector that are suffering more during the COVID-19 situation is the tertiary sector. Because people is not going anywhere and only consume what is necessary for their life. They do not consume something luxury, they do not consume the tertiary and secondary consumption.
All right, so we talk much about 2021 state budget deficit, but when we talk about 2020 deficit, government just set up 6.3% of the state budget deficit. But in the other hand, sir, we know that international institutions just stated that Indonesia might have a larger deficit. So do you think that this 6.3%, this number can be widened up?
I think that is possible. But the good thing is this year, as the global economy is slumping, the demand for the liquidity worldwide, not only in Indonesia, is dropping also. So currently, we have very ample liquidity in the market, so the government should finance its widening deficit. I still be comfortable with the tax budget deficit to reach 7.5%. That should be reasonable number for me.
All right, sir. So when we talk about state budget deficit, also it has a strong correlations with, recessions. This recession is huge. Do you think that Indonesia will have this?
Pardon me.
That Indonesia will have recessions in the meantime?
We are putting for that, but we need to be ready with that situation. Because at the current situation, as so many companies already laying off the already reduced the number of the employees, so it is likely that to gain back the consumption is likely to take more time. We need to be ready that the first quarter of this year, the economic growth is still in negative time. We need to be ready with that.
All right, sir. And when we talk about funding, this is very interesting. Since to plug the deficit number, government tried to try several methods. One of them is issuing global bonds and government bonds and whatever it is issuing the bonds. And you know, according to data, government expects to raise more than 1.5 quadrillion rupiah for bonds. What's your perspective about this?
My perspective is here. There is ample liquidity in the market, both in the local and the global market. In the local market, if you look at the June data, the loan growth in the banking system is only 1%, with the spread between the deposit and the loan in the banking system is already exceeding 600 billion. That's from the local, it means that there is a plenty of idle money in our banking system. From the global perspective, the Fed already stated that they maintain the interest rate close to zero.
All right.
So, with the current situation and the current difficulty, I do think 1.5 quadrillion of bonds could be financed by our government. That should be okay.
All right, sir.
That should be okay. What we need to focus is how to gain the confidence from the investors to put the money to Indonesia. Since this year, there is so many countries that could be financed by the international money.
All
if
right,
we
sir.
Could convince the investor next year, we will have a better GDP growth. I think 1.51 billion wouldn't be a problem.
It is indeed a quite interesting point of view, sir. And yes, sir, by widening state budget deficit, we hope government can use the fund as efficient as possible, sir, and soon can devise appropriate policy responses as well. And sir, thank you for your time with us, sir. Good evening. And yes, here stay tuned to market headlines because we will be right back after this quick break.